Welcome to Warn, today's top stories are China preparing to send man to the moon. China is making preliminary preparations to send a man to the moon, the latest goal in the country's ambitious lunar exploration program. China in 2003 became the third country to put a man in space with its own rocket after the former Soviet Union and the United States. It has touted its plans for moon exploration and in late 2013 completed the first lunar soft landing since 1976 with the Chang'e 3 craft and its Jade Rabbit rover. The country also plans to land the first probe ever on the dark side of the moon in 2018, another milestone. Yang Liwei, Deputy Director General of China Manned Space Agency and China's first man in space, said it will not take long for the manned mission to the moon to get official approval and funding, state news agency Xinhua said late on Tuesday. The report gave no other details, but such a trip could still be many years off. A government official said last year that China wants to put astronauts on the moon by 2036. In what state media said was the country's first confirmation of a manned lunar exploration program. MOD will place an order for 6 more regiments of the extended-range Pinaka rocket launchers. A repeat tender for Pinaka rocket launchers appears to be in the offing with the Defense Ministry looking to buy 6 regiments. One regiment is 18 systems of the homemade weapons system. Touted as one of the first Create in India product, the Pinaka is designed and developed by 2 private companies, the Tatas and Larsen & Toubro, L&T, in association with the Armament Research and Development Establishment of the DRDO. Confirming the development, and the private entities wait for the request for proposal, RFP, Jayunt Patel, Senior Vice President and Head Defense and Aerospace, L&T, told Business Line, "We expect the commercial RFP for the next 6 regiments to be issued within the coming few weeks. Thereafter, contracting is likely to be completed during FY18. Indian Army prepared for a 2.5 front war, Army Chief Bipin Rawat. Chief of Army Staff General Bipin Rawat, in an interaction with ANI, said that the Indian Army is well prepared to face external, as well as internal threats to the country. Speaking to ANI, General Bipin Rawat said, "Indian Army is fully ready for a 2.5 front war." The Army Chief added that even though India is ready for a multi-front war, there are effective mechanisms available to defuse an adverse situation. Even the PM has stated that for the last 40 years not even a single bullet has been fired on the Indochina border, said General Rawat. In a freewheeling conversation with ANI, General Rawat also informed that a new strike corps, 17 Strike Corps, is being raised specifically for mountain warfare. On asking about the delay in its raising, Army Chief said a process as complex as this takes time. He said, "It is being raised from scratch. The recruitments are on. As it is, to prepare an Army soldier it takes about 3 years from recruitment process to training and then orienting and finally their deployment." General Rawat went on to discuss modernization plans of the Army, saying that the government is aware of our all needs and is supporting us in every manner. "Make in India is a good initiative, it will give results in 2 to 3 years," said General Rawat. General Rawat added that all armies across the world maintain an inventory in the ratio of the 30-40-30. Here 30% equipment is state-of-the-art technology, 40% is undergoing modernization and the rest 30% is obsolete, which requires an upgrade. Tata Advanced Systems delivers crown and tail cone for Chapter 47 Chinook helicopter to Boeing. Boeing and Tata Advanced Systems Limited, TASL, announced the delivery of the first crown and tail cone assembly for the Indian configuration of the Chapter 47F Chinook helicopter on Thursday. Manufactured by TASL in Hyderabad, the parts will be delivered to Boeing for final assembly of the 15 helicopters on delivery to the Indian Air Force, a TASL statement said. Boeing India President Pratyush Kumar said, "This delivery is another significant step in our journey to increase defense capability and manufacturing capacity out of India with our strategic partners. Tata Advanced Systems has demonstrated its ability to deliver high-quality components to the Chapter CH-47 Chinook program on schedule, which in turn helps Boeing meet commitments to our customers. We have clearly invested in leveraging the full potential of capability that exists in India to continue delivering greater value for less cost to our US and international customers, he added. Undertaking the responsibility of complete manufacture and assembly for Boeing gives us an excellent opportunity to display our capability of development and assembly projects in high technology areas to global quality standards, said TASL Chief Executive Officer and Managing Director Sukaran Singh. The Defense Ministry finalized an order with Boeing in 2015 for the production, training and support of 15 Chapter 47F Chinook heavy lift helicopters to enhance India's capabilities across a range of military and humanitarian missions. Deliveries are expected to begin in 2019. TASL is already delivering crown and tail cones for Chapter 47 Chinook helicopters for the US Army and international customers. The Chapter 47F Chinook is the advanced multi-mission helicopter which is being operated by the American Army and 18 other defense forces around the world. Boeing's network in India includes 35 direct and 120 indirect suppliers from India that manufacture advanced and complex components and sub-assemblies for a range of various commercial and defense aircraft such as the 787 Dreamliner, 777X, F/A, 18, F-15, P-8, Chapter 47 Chinook and A-64 Apache. HAL Scout's overseas partner for multirole Helo engines India's state-owned Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, or HAL, has floated a global request for information for the purchase of engines to power its homemade multirole helicopter. Having designed the helicopter, there is very little else that HAL has on its table, except setting up manufacturing facilities. Even the avionics of the IMRH will be imported, said Vijayinder Thakur, a defense analyst and retired Indian Air Force squadron leader, referring to the Indian multirole helicopter. HAL, which is India's sole aircraft and helicopter producer, is developing the 12.5-ton class multirole helicopter with a service ceiling of about 20,000 feet and a 3,500-kilogram payload. The company is aiming to freeze the preliminary design of its IMRH so it can be built over the next 18 months. Safran of France is a preferred HAL partner for helicopter engines, having visited India in May 2017 to discuss the requirement, Thakur said, adding that Ukraine is pitching its variant of the Mi-17 helicopter engine. Around 200 of the helicopters are proposed to be built for use by the Indian Defence Forces, including the Indian Navy, Air Force and Army for tactical troop movement, heliborne and amphibious assault, anti-submarine warfare, and anti-surface operations. An Indian Ministry of Defence official, however, said HAL cannot go ahead without the support of and clear visibility from government. If support comes from leading foreign origin equipment manufacturers for engines, landing gear and so on, then it would take easily 8 to 10 years for development, the MOD official said. China rolls out export trainer/fighter aircraft. The first export variant of China's new FTC-2000 pilot trainer/fighter aircraft has rolled off an assembly line and will be shipped to Sudan after testing. The FTC-2000 Shanying was developed by the Gizhou Aviation Industry Corporation under the state-owned Aviation Industry Corporation of China. It is the main advanced trainer used by the PLA Air Force and the PLA Navy. It can be used for senior training, elementary combat training and tactical countermeasure training for fighter pilots, Chinese news agency Xinhua quoted Hu Jianxing, deputy manager and chief designer with the AVIC Gizhou Aviation Industry Corporation. And it also has the ability to perform air-to-air and air-to-ground combat. The trainer/fighter is a single-engine supersonic aircraft. Its maiden flight was on December 13, 2003. The domestic version and export version have the same flying platform, Hu said. And both are installed with China's home-developed WP-13 turbojet engine, which has been tested for high performance. The export version will be installed with various avionics systems, navigation guidance systems or external stores tailored for overseas clients' demand for multiple missions. China-built Myanmar military plane carrying 120 people crashes. 15 passengers have reportedly survived a plane crash after military aircraft carrying more than 100 people vanished over Myanmar. Local media reported 120 servicemen and their families were aboard the flight from Myik to Yangon when it disappeared on Wednesday afternoon. Debris from the aircraft was found near Dai following reports the plane had crashed. 15 people are said to have survived. No information is known on their condition. The plane went missing at 1:35 p.m. local time, 7:05 a.m. UK time, as it flew from Myik to Yangon, the country's army said. A major search and rescue effort has been scrambled to search for the plane, which was 20 miles west of Dai over the Andaman Sea when it lost communication and vanished. Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, Warn.